Hey guys, what's going on? Eagle here. I'm not gonna lie, I recorded this episode already. I got to the Elite Four, I got to level 55, I got to the Elite Four, was battling Drake, and my computer blue screened. Timestamp me, put the blue screen on the screen a whole, 20 seconds in. And yeah. Normally, I tried to recover the video. I lost the audio, I tried to recover the video footage, and it couldn't work, so. I'm just gonna get back to grinding. Let's get into position. All I did, I grinded for like 45 minutes. And then I took on the Elite Four, so. Let me get items in position. I'm gonna switch the Lucky Egg around. Actually, let me switch Groudon here. I wanna get Groudon up too. Good Groudon way up there, so yeah. I'm probably gonna save intermittently because. Well, I don't know. Let's get to grinding. Timestamp me, start the grind montage. Alright, timestamp me getting a Jinx that knows Psychic. Yeah, bud. Hell yeah. All right, let's get back to it, shall we?
We'll be right back.
Yo. Yo, synthesis. That's gonna be good. Especially because I'll always have Sunny Grout on. Synthesis for sleep powder. I can mess. Essentially, one rung below toxic stalling. Alright. We're almost there, guys. I promise. We're almost there. Timestamp me 52 minutes into the recording. Grind session done. Everyone viable is at level 55 or plus. I have major eye strain. Let's go over what we got. At level 55, master. Level 57, Venusaur with synthesis, which will be boosted off of Sunny Day, which I believe would yield 3/4 health back. So Synthesis Poison Powder is going to be a fantastic strat. Snorlax, the Death Fodder. Nikki, the Jinx, at 53. She needs to be grinded up a little more. Psychic, Powder Snow, Body Slam. If I had time, if I had Fly, I would go to Lilycove, Frigate Flash, go to Fall Arbor, I think, and then relearn Twin Needle or something. And then Magmar, MVP, level 55. So I am ready. I'm ready to go. See, I was concerned I would have a advantage that since I've already battled mostly Elite Four, but I've honestly forgotten what they have. So I'm going to go with Master first and foremost. Alright. Shit, fuck me. I didn't buy items. Well, damn. Okay. Rookie mistake. That's fine. Life goes on. At least I healed. Actually going to pull up the Elite Four specs so I can know what levels I'm going into. That was the Mightyena at 46. This guy has my 246s, 248s, and a 49. This is going to be easy. Real easy battle. My strat before is going to be the same thing. I actually, in the past episode, I did not get Venusaur up to this level, and it did not learn synthesis. I abandoned Venusaur, and I actually lost Venusaur, so I missed what it said. Oh, I did this in the last episode, too. I forgot. It's gonna go for Psychic. Now I'm gonna switch back to his Master to take the Psychic. I don't know. I'm 9 levels higher, but a Psychic is terrifying. A Psychic off an Alakazam is terrifying. If it did that damage to me, it would have probably done even more. Let's see if I can get off a Fire Blast. Oh god. Yes, boosted Fire Blast should do it. Barely. I don't think I get this Future Sight attack at this time. Yes, I do. It shouldn't do anything. It shouldn't do much. Okay, thank God. Going into Elite Four with 5 Hyper Potions has just been a bad idea. I might lose this. Earthquake may one-shot it. It's at least a 2-hit KO. I forget. A 1-hit KO, because Alakazam has pretty bad defense. Really good special defense. That's right, it brings in the Kingler. Comeback Kid should be able to tank the Future Sight pretty decently. I think Razor Leaf has such a high PP, and I did in this go through want to get Comeback Kid that much higher, because Razor Leaf is a lower... Razor Leaf isn't a very good move. Yeah, I'll switch into Bib. That's sort of spread around. I'm going to actually use Fire Punch on Bib to save flamethrowers when I need them. Boosted Fire Punch should do good things. And I'll take the... Should take the features I attack now. Okay, well, whatever. Maybe... I don't remember. Whatever. Alright, one down. Next up is Phoebe. I gotta be very conservative about my items now. I'm just gonna go in with Master again, get that sunlight up. Fun fact, I used to think Phoebe was pronounced Phoeb. Or Phoebe? Phoebe? When I was a child, when I was a wee little fourth grader playing Pokemon Sapphire. Poliwrath? Okay. I do remember all of this. Honestly, my strat's gonna be the exact same. At $5, he uses Hypnosis on me. Submission. Oof. Yeah, submission doesn't do much since I'm a poison type. I don't know why he's not going for hypnosis though. I would go for hypnosis and submission. Okay. Maybe I can get off a paralysis on this one. We've just crossed over an hour of power, although you're not gonna know that hour of power, because more than half of it's gonna be sped up at like 350 times speed. Come on, crit. Come on, ooh, fuck yeah, bud. That wasn't a crit, really. I guess that that was a crit. No, it wasn't. Weird. At least Poliwrath is down. Lanoon. Okay, yeah. That's right. This is the exact same that I did in the last video. I switched back into Master, and I set up on the Lanoon. The Lanoon will probably only use Slash. I can get up 6 bulk ups. Well, probably 3 because I don't have very... I'll do 3 bulk ups. Since I don't have very many healing items. This really puts I am also level 55, so I should only need... I'll go for 2 bulk ups. You know what? That's what I'm gonna do. 2 bulk ups. I think Lanoon. I'm gonna go for an earthquake. I want to save the fire blasts. Boosted fire blast in case of emergency. Just like boosted earthquake in case of emergency. Awesome. Yo, Comeback had learned Solar Beam at level 60. Yo, if I can use Solar Beam, I don't think I'll get two levels. I'm going for another bulk up, that's right. I did 4 bulk ups, or I did 5 bulk ups versus the Lanoon, and then I did a final bulk up versus the Nidoran, because the Nidoran can't do anything. It can do Flatter, yes! God damn it, I forgot Flatter. Oh. I have to use a full heal. No. I have a lot of full heals though, which is nice. Anything else for Crunch, which is honestly really weird for a Nidoran to have. It does some pretty decent damage for a little Nidoran. I am gonna go for the Earthquake to get it off my screen. Although, I wasn't sure if Ancient Power would do it, because it's not Stab or super effective or boosted, so I wasn't for sure. No buffs except for the +3. And I think I even... on this gen, HP power may be physical. Swablu? Yeah, I remember you. I was using HP power versus Swablu. I need to save my PP. I save my PPs. I do want to get this thing off my screen as soon as possible because it knows Fissure. And it did not hit in the last lost recordings, but it may hit in this, so I wanted to get it off. Okay, two down on the Glacia. Glacia has 250s, 252s, and 53. My HP is growing up, probably not. Yeah, I'm gonna stick with it. Earlier, there's a feature to, feature in the randomizer that would re-randomize trainers in case, you know, in this instance of lost footage, you wouldn't have... In the case of lost footage, you wouldn't have, you know... You wouldn't have an advantage. This is gonna hurt. Though not very much. See if I can get a scumbag 4-star. See if I can get some scumbag boost off of Angel Power. That'd be nice. Yeah, I probably could have predicted the protect. I should have predicted the protect. Wasted PP is not good. At least it fails the second time. Cradilly. Yeah. Should be able to one-shot Cradilly with Earthquake. It's neutral, stab, with a +1 and attack. I'm gonna switch in for the Sand Slash. I'm gonna go to Comeback Kid. I need to save my Groudon's PP. Giggity. I think she has one more. I may end up actually using Synthesis on the next turn. I'm switching out. The Donphan is... I remember the Donphan being very bad. Very bad news. Nikki, come on out. Come on out, girl. Let me get a scumbag freeze. That'd be nice. Yeah, this knife has Earthquake as power. Wow. Alright. 107. I will be able to outspeed it though in this. And I'll be able to outspeed it and man, I wasted a lot of time on that. Well, I guess the Jinx did get me, did help me out. It didn't just die in vain, it wasn't death fodder. And yeah, this stupid Feraligatr was also, well. I'm gonna go for the synthesis. Don't do anything stupid. Slash is fine. I think Rage Leaf's gonna be a two-hit KO, I think, unless it gets a crit, it's gonna be a one-hit KO. I think. Yeah. Oh, you are just too kind. With a scary face mist. And so this has the guy has a citrus berry. Which, as I said in the previous episode, in the previous recording, only heals 30 health in this game, as opposed to other to newer games where I believe it heals 30%. So, all right, three down. I'm gonna save after this in case I blue screen, because I did blue screen on Drake. Man, this is a lot of editing. A lot of timestamps. It's literally only three, just one timestamp is from timestamp 1 through 52. Save. Okay. I'm gonna heal Master so I can berry-wise, have any or no? I have two citrus berries. I'm gonna use those. See, in the previous recording, I was smart before I went towards the Elite Four, and I sold literally everything in my bag and bought full restores. I did not buy elixirs though, which is where I, well, it was my mistake last time. In this game, my mistake was forgetting to buy anything at all, so whatever. I'm gonna do a quick cut and save this footage because I'm really concerned this is gonna blue screen again. Hold on. Alright, I'm back. So we got another Lanoon. Sinking. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Had to do that because I don't want to waste any moment, so I did a not invisible sink. I usually sink on the start menu. It's for syncing my footage together with my audio and video recordings. Of course, Fire Blast misses. There you go. Usually does not miss two in a row. Really, it didn't die? I can use Ancient Power and kill it. I don't have Ancient Power. Earthquake. It's gonna use Full Restore. Yes. God damn it. Well, Earthquake should kill it. I forget Fire Blast is a special. Earthquake is physical. Very good. I was technically on a no bonus. So that was plus 2 in attack, he was plus 2 in defense. Alright. Okay. I did not get this far. I am actually ahead. I died. I blue screened on the Tentacruel. Very nice, very nice. I'm gonna stay in. Snatch. And the Carvana, that's fine. Let's go come back, kid. That's a one hit. Actually might learn Solar Beam in the next battle. That'd be hilarious. Alright, let's heal. Before I... anyone... nope, no one. Okay, just making sure no one can learn Karate Chop. I want to heal up Master. Give leftovers to Master. Don't need the Lucky Egg anymore. Yo, actually though, I'm gonna give the Soft Sand to Master. Boost that already boosted Earthquake. Give the leftovers to Babe. And come back. I want to leave the experience here and come back here. In case I can, you know, get that solar beam. Alright. I'm going to save just in case. I blue screen during this battle. So if it cuts out, I will explain everything. Alright. Zip. Gonna be flashbacks to when I was a little kid. Wallace has a full team of 6, has a 57, 55, 56, 56, 56, 58. 58's gonna really be a pain in the ass. I'm gonna go for an immediate switch and a comeback, kid. And Crab Hatter misses, thank God. It's a one-hit KO. Thank you. So far, so good. That was a Wailord. Unrandomized, so it's kind of cool as a water type. Snorunt. Okay. Beb. Snort is usually a 10 accrual, I believe. If it's the other 55, it is a 10 accrual. Or if it's 55, I should say. 56? Okay, it could be a Whiscas, Ludicolo, or Gyarados. Fuck it, Flamethrower. All in. I missed it, whatever. Clamperl, that's nothing. I can take that. I'm just gonna use Flamethrower, honestly. Boosted Stab. This Water Gun probably won't do much. Yeah, nah, it didn't do anything. This is the tentacle, by the way. Okay. Okay, T-Tar is gonna whip up Sandstream. Switching to Master. Earthquake will then get boosted. Okay, Master's gonna do this. Master's finishing the battle. Master will could die before I switch him out, honestly. Sandstream boosts ground attacks. Earthquake boosted Earthquake Stab and with the sand thing? Bruh. Is unstoppable. I also only have 2 PP. So, there's that. Which is bad. One hit. Bye-bye. Level 56. Bruh. Bring it on. Legend v. Legend. Fuck yeah. His last Pokemon's a Clefairy. I am so happy. His Milotic is a level 58 Clefairy. Bro. I got this in the bag. Thank you, good old RNG. What do you have? Citrus Berry? Citrus Berry, yeah, that's fine. Disrespect Sandstorm damage won the battle. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes Pokemon Emerald. I have goosebumps, man. Oh. 28 episodes. Oh yeah, you missed it. You're getting the hang of it. I'm the champion, old man. has finally come on. My MVP. My other MVP. Some death fodder. Some unnecessary death fodder. Other MVP. And death fodder. What a mixed bag of amazingness. Yo, these credits almost make me cry. I might start crying. This credit scene was almost as sad as the XY credit scene, and that credit scene was just tear jerking. Oh, it's all randomized too. That's amazing. Yo, Venomoth, my boy. Baltoy, Snowrunt. Oh. Yo. Wait, those may be all my Pokemon that I've had before. Yo, the misses and Snowball. Pre-game MVPs went down, died too early. Haunter, Blaziken. Yeah, these are all Pokemon in my box. The stupid egg that happened to be a Geodude. Charizard that died, Dylan, the misses, Snicky, Beb, Snorlax, man, I'm on the verge of tears. Master, Jumpluff, Gainesville. As we go down this emotional train wreck known as me, I want to thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, remember to leave a like and smash that like button. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram at EagleTJM. And you know the usual. Do me a solid and have a great day. Goosebumps everywhere. Did I catch a survivor at some point? I think I must have. Yeah, Haunter, the Gengar that never was, would have probably died exactly the same way that Jinx died. Accidental death fodder. Because they're so glassy. Why is this so emotional? Because this is the best Pokemon game ever created, in my opinion. It's my first game I played, or one of the first games I played. Good thing to end on. Thanks, guys.